Hey, what's up, you guys? This is your boy, Kerry D. Singleton, and I'm here with Intrigue Magazine, and we're here at the Queens Theater in Flushing Meadow, Corona Park, for the intimate, up-close, and personal concert with your man, Keith Washington, featuring Intro, Full Force, and Monique Nikkole. It's going to be a great night of R&B smoothness, and I just can't wait. We're here, Intrigue Magazine is going to cover everything for you. I'm here on the red carpet, and we're going to have a great time. Stay tuned.
Without no further ado, ladies and gentlemen, most of the ladies, it's been a long time before this man came to the New York City area. You know, I had got on his case real quick because he was on tour with Will Downey before, you know, just very recently. So, without no further ado, straight from the West Side. Ladies, are you ready?
Yes.
Wait, I can't hear you. Ladies, are you ready?
Yes.
Fellas, hold on tight at that one time. Just let go just for a little bit, for like maybe 25 minutes. Because when you go home, you're going to have some fun. Mr. Keith Washington.
Oh,
so much, huh? It's been a long time. I know, brother, I know. If you know this song, this was on my first CD. It's called When You Love Somebody and Somebody Loves You Back. Clap your hands, come on now. Yeah, yeah.
Guys, we're here in the dressing room for the headliner tonight. It was a great show with Mr. Keith Washington. He definitely lit up the stage. And I believe this brother, as I pay quite close attention to his performance. Show the art of using his voice as an instrument, Mr. Keith Washington. Thank you for being here today and coming out to Queens and giving us some classics. So how's it feel to be you right now?
It feels good, man. It always feels good to be me. High, lows, and drama is still me, you know what I mean? But, you know, it's not what you go through. It's how you come out of it. And right now, I'm glad I pulled this off considering that I was just getting over cold and whatnot. Okay. But at the end of the day, you just go on what you know what I mean? And we put it out, and it was good, and enjoyed it, people enjoyed it, and I'm happy to be here in Queens, man.
Now, in the 90s, you were, you know, in my opinion, and the opinion of a lot of different people who are fans of your music, like the 90s reincarnation of a mixture between Marvin Gaye and Teddy Pendergrass. How does it feel to be compared to or put in the same sentence as those legendary crooners who basically mesmerized the ladies with their voices?
Wow, that's a compliment, first of all. And for them to have shoulders such as a guy like me to be able to stand on them and learn from them is a blessing, too. I mean, they have paved the way for what we do. Mm-hmm. Myself, Keith Sweat, different artists that's out there, right. Johnny Gill, all of us. You know, I'm pretty sure we all learned from these icons, you know. Yes. And it's amazing you should mention Teddy. He's been like a mentor of mine for many years. And mm-hmm. Marvin, I met him one time in my life as a young kid.
Wow.
But I had the opportunity to play him in the play called My Brother Marvin.
Nice.
That his sister Zeola Gay wrote. And they often say that I remind them of their brother Marvin in many ways, not just performing him, but just in my everyday walk of life and being around them. Mm-hmm. So it's a compliment, man. There's only one Marvin, and there's only one Teddy. And what we do is pick up things from these people and learn from them, you know, from their professional career as far as music. Personal life, every individual have to go through that themselves.
Right, right.
But musically, it's a pleasure to be compared to them. It's a funny story. When I was first nominated for a Grammy, mm-hmm. I was very excited about it. I think I just came off of winning a Soul Train Award.
Right, right.
And I was very excited about the Grammys. If anybody know anything about the Grammys, it's very tough to even be nominated.
Yeah. Well, not nowadays.
Well, yeah.
But back in the day when talent, yeah.
Day, it was very tough. The board was different. It was basically all white,
yep.
You know.
Absolutely.
And this particular time, and me being my first time nominated, why am I in the category with all these male singers that I admire? Peter Bryson, mm. Jeffrey Osborne, Teddy Pendergrass, Luther Vandross, mm. Barry White, all my icons that I loved.
Right.
I didn't have a chance in winning, but I didn't give a damn if I won or not, because being in that presence
right.
of these generals, you know what I mean?
Right.
And these captains, man, but of course, Luther won, but it was just a pleasure, man, of seeing people that I love the most and I've learned from to be in that category. I won,
right.
as far as I'm concerned.
Of course.
You know?
Absolutely. Well, let me say this. You've said there's only one Teddy Pendergrass. You've said that there's only one Marvin Gaye. Well, brother, there's only one Keith Washington. And tonight, you know, you brought the house down. Not just the ladies, but the fellas loved your performance. It's a wonderful thing when you make music that transcends time, and you can, with your voice, take people back to a point in their lives where they remember, you know, a happy moment or maybe even a sad moment. I want to ask you a question. What was it like working with the beautiful and extraordinarily talented Shantae Moore?
It was cool, man. She's truly like my little sister, man. I mean, if you saw us together, you would probably just laugh because we are so humble toward each other, but yet so silly toward one another as well. We respect each other's talent, but we also love each other's emotion or where we come from, our spirituality. Just everything about her is real,
mm-hmm.
and I respect it, although we clown each other all the time. I mean, there's times we have concerts and we're doing our duets and I'm singing and she's doing the most silliest faces that the audience can't even see.
Right, right.
And we would see who can break character. I mean, it would be the craziest stuff. But at the same time, it's beautiful. I mean, I've known Sean since the beginning of time. When I say that, we've known each other before we had records out.
Wow, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you all have a friendship
years before.
Right, right. Okay.
And what happened was my record came out, and we were touring, and Mr. Louis Silas, that owns Silas MCA Records, mm-hmm. I was on Soul Train, taping Soul Train with Destiny's Child, and he came down there, and he says, Keaton, he's like my brother. He says, Keith, I signed this girl, man. Now, I ain't seen Sean in like a couple of years, mm-hmm. you know, because I've been doing my thing.
Right.
And he said, I signed this girl, man, and to make a long story short, he said, she's in the green room, man. You may know her. You know, he knew I know her, but it was a surprise because right. Sean told her, I know that's my brother. Ain't seen her in years. So I go into the green room, and there's Shantae. Mm. And I'm like, are you the one he just signed? Silas MCA. So the reason why they came there, he did sign her. And the conversation went on that we knew each other. And he thought it was a great combination like Marvin Gaye and Tammy Terrell. Mm. So we did House Party Last 2.
Yeah.
The House Party 2 was Candlelight New.
Right.
And we did that. And just so happened, after we did it, I started touring. Mm-hmm. So as she working on the album, I'm touring. So what better? And the record was like in the top 10.
Huge.
With
record.
No video.
Huge.
And that was politics, but no video, and the record was soaring. So the record got in the top 5. We had that put on tour. And the way my stage was set up, we set a stage up where when we got to that song, she was way at the top. You know, we had this ramp built, she's way at the top and all black, and all the stage was black with lights like this going down the stairs, and when we got the Candlelight, you couldn't see her but a silhouette. And because she's attractive,
right.
you knew the men and the women was going to like her because she's a likable individual.
Correct.
She came down them stairs, man, and as she came down the stairs, you saw more of her face, more of her face, more of her face. Mm. And then when she got to the top of the stairs, Mike, man, listen, she was like awesome. And she told me for a while, and that helped set her record up,
right,
you know.
Okay.
But she's like my sister. We got something coming out on my new record, and we're very excited about that. But I love her to death.
Candlelight and You was probably the best known duet.
Let's say one of them.
But we discussed this before this interview that my favorite Keith Washington song, period, is I Love You.
Yeah. Man.
Beautiful album cut that when I was in my early 20s, late teens. I played it over and over and over and over. I'm going to give you the mic because I want you to talk to me about that record. What was it like recording that record?
That was, Candlelight You was easy. First of all, people don't realize Shantae wrote Candlelight You.
Mm-hmm.
She wrote that and produced that with Lainey Stewart. We were in the studio together,
okay.
You know, from ad-libs, and we did it all together. I Love You, now we've become both successful.
Right.
So now it's very difficult to get us in the studio
Same
together.
Studio, right, right.
So I went in to cut my part. And she had to go, when I cut my part, she had to go around. No, she had cut her part first. When I flew in off the road, I went in and cut my parts, and I had to ad-lib around her ad-libs. You know what I mean? But overall, man, it was very interesting, very exciting. A lot of people don't know that Shanice Wilson wrote that song.
I didn't know that.
Shanice Wilson wrote I Love You. And let me tell you, brother, had you heard the demo that she presented?
Mm.
It was just her singing I Love You. It was not even considered a duet.
Okay, it was just a...
They converted it, from what I know, to a duet.
Mm.
But when I tell you Shanice Wilson put her foot in this song, she put her foot in this song.
Great record.
What's wrong with Shantae doing? Because I know Shantae's a star at this time. Mm-hmm. So is Shanice Wilson. But the world know Keith and Shantae.
Right.
And second thing, Shantae is going to make it her. And right. That's what she did.
Right.
And she killed it as well.
It was a great record, man. I'm glad to, know that you're still, after all the time. Because the music industry has transitioned.
It's crazy,
the talent pool. A lot of times when I interview recording artists, I know you guys got to keep it humble. And you got to keep it, cool. I'm going to say that the talent pool has gone to the dogs, especially in R&B. That's just my opinion.
You talk to, though. Some people are just right out raw. And I tell you, everybody sound alike.
Yeah,
the music sound alike.
Yeah.
There's no originality. And I say the same shit. It's no big deal.
Okay, thank you.
No.
So Keith Washington and High Five actually agree with me on camera.
And I understand something. There's nothing wrong with that. We all learn from somebody.
Right.
We all got some things from somebody. And, they all learn from Michael Jackson. Those that sound like, learn, you can tell they learn from Michael.
Right.
They not Michael, but they talented
right.
within
anyway,
the era
right.
where they are.
Yeah,
Usher, good associate of mine. Love him to death, man. Bad brother. can't hate on him. Right. But everybody have, during their era, their mentor.
Right, exactly.
You know, and so I don't hate on any of that, but at the same time, where's the originality?
Right.
See, back in the day, we'll hear a song and we'll take some out of it, but we are totally flipping and creative. All right, I'm speaking of, let's not just say, because melody, the majority, 95% of melodies out there is different.
Right.
But the artist emulates or sound like somebody else, in a sense.
Yeah.
But it's themselves. It's the production that gives you 16, all that stuff. Every instrument basically sounds the same.
Right.
So what happens is, we tend, I mean, if you took every vocal off every track today, okay, and listen to them, you say, oh, that shit sound the same as this person. That's not, because the tracks, because everybody want those 16ths.
Yeah.
Everybody want this. Everybody, and there's no really originality stuff. You know, I love Dre. I love all these guys, man. But I'm an artist as well. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. If that shit's paying your bills and you getting paid, do your thing.
It is what it is.
In the morning, this is the time of games begin. I feel your mind is shaking, because you know just what I'm thinking. So let's lie here on the floor, babe, cause my bed looks too far gone, and I just wanna get into you, and I'm doing a damn thing you won't keep to do.
Oh,
love this song. I actually wrote this song for Anita Baker, but they told me to keep it for myself. Even though the album went platinum, her shit went triple platinum. I would have been rich. Take it out.
Felt I needed an urgency. Cause if you were lying, fresh on my mind. And as I reached to pull you close to me, imagine the ecstasy, love. You so gently in every way. Oh,
so much. And like I said, that was for Anita Baker, and I chose to keep it for myself. My shit was platinum. Hers was triple platinum. But damn it, it was good for me, you know? This song here, wait a minute, can I come back there? Ladies, right here, huh? Y'all should just come on to the front. Y'all too far back. Come on, bring your butts on now, front. Come on now. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Say it over.
Now I said, that's not a diss to none of my young brothers that's out there, because we all learn from somebody.
Right.
And there's somebody, trust me, that's learning from Usher, that's learning from Chris Brown, that's learning from these little young icons out there today.
But I just wish, this is just me personally, I just wish a lot more of them would learn from you. I'm going to say this,
more
brother.
More originality.
More originality, and as a songwriter, I'm a writer. And so I respect lyrics, and I respect passion. And a very dear friend of mine, Renee Lynch, and I were watching your performance, and we both had to agree that you were able to stand there with a microphone and entertain with your voice, with your charisma, and with your diction. That's all I'm saying. You know, there's a certain, that's yeah.
And once again, it goes back to who you learn from.
Right.
I grew up in the Marvin was grew up with my mother's in the era, but I had records because they played them. I learned from Marvin. I learned from I mean, quick story. When I was young, I was in a group. We drove to Philadelphia International hoping to get a record deal from Philadelphia International. I was like 18 years old, or 18, 19, somewhere around that. Like, and I was 17, actually.
Okay.
And me and the Spider-Man group out of Detroit, we drove to Philly. No appointment.
This is the old-fashioned way.
Small gangster hoping that we run to whoever we thought was famous to get us in.
Right.
Just happened, I think it was Bunny Sigler or Tom Bell. One of them was coming out.
Okay.
And we bum rushed him. And for some, and he didn't trip. He said, "Y'all come on in." And we was like, "Damn, it's working." We talked to him. That's when the TP album had just came out. It wasn't released
yet. Right, okay.
And I wanted a copy of that album, right? Because I saw him in his office. So we talking. I'm just gonna show you how things transcend and things work. So he heard the CD. He said, "I love y'all. Y'all got a great sound. Who's that guy?" And I was doing, and they said it's him. I was the youngest one in the group. They was all like about 5-6 years older than me.
Okay.
And they said it's him. He says, "You got a great voice." He says, "Obvious who your mentor is." He says, "But there's something in that voice that you're not releasing, and it's you."
Wow.
I was like, "Well, this is all I know." I mean, you know, but so what I did as an artist that took that adhesive, because there's already a Teddy Pendergrass.
Right.
Even though I'm a baritone, second tenor, and first natural, my baritone is obviously natural. So I've been so many places. It's just naturally that.
Right.
So many things, none kinds. You know what I mean? It's just that, you know, and learning from all these icons, I put them all in one with me. But here's the deal. He said, "There's already a Teddy Pendergrass."
Right.
He said, "There's obviously that's your mentor, but there's something in you that's incredible that you have to release." So what I did, because I was such a fan of Teddy's, there's not a song or run or riff. Even when I'm not doing him, I find myself there because I learned from him.
Right.
I went home and said, "How do I get out of this whole Teddy thing?" Well, what I did is start listening to people like Phyllis Hyman.
Mm-hmm.
I started listening to a lot of female singers because I can't sound like them.
Right, exactly.
I just have to sing their songs. "I was just a writer once, so I needed the answers, you." I just could do me.
You had to do you.
I had to, and I struggled with that shit. You know, because I was, "The answer is you." But it was like, I struggled with it, but it brought originality to me as an artist. A lot of cats don't do that.
Right.
You know what
exactly.
I mean? They get lucky, and their luck goes on, or they get with the right people, and that's cool too. No disrespect. And I say that consistently because there's no disrespect.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever you get your talent from and however you get it, that's cool. But I learned from women, listening to women, jazz singers, listening to people that I knew I couldn't sing like.
Right.
And that gave me, because I'm a male vocalist, that gave me originality.
Mm.
And with the combination of me automatically being a baritone second of Teddy and just the natural first of different people, artists that I know, and listening to them, it all came together and it created me.
Wow.
You know?
Wow.
There's not an artist today, I tell you right now, that can tell you the same story I told them. I'm telling you. Because they ain't going to go listen to women.
Right.
Ain't nobody going to go listen to Rihanna.
Well.
I'm talking about guys that are going to try to sound like,
I would hope.
Let me leave that alone.
We're talking about singers here. Right?
No, I'm talking about,
That's just me, not you.
I know.
It's just me.
No, because I like her shit. I really do.
He likes her.
Because I try to learn something from everything I listen to.
They should learn more from you, though.
And no disrespect. And I get that. And I appreciate you saying that, brother. But what I'm saying is there's something. I tried to figure out what made this shit triple platinum. But then you got to understand.
The world may never know.
But so my point is this. It's like, then I understand the generation.
Yeah.
Somebody left the door open.
Wide open.
You know what I mean?
So, closed it.
So that's what it is. But guess what? It is what it is. And real music is fun doing its way back. Because guess what? How much can you listen to one song? When I say one song, many of them sing the same song.
Yes, you listen to the same song 20 times a day. But let me just say this. One thing about you, brother, and I'm going to say this again, is that, and so many of my contemporaries agree with this comment, that good music does not have a shelf life at all. Okay, so when good music is recorded, good music can always be listened to over and over and over. And I personally want to thank you for bringing us, giving us, and obviously so does Dwayne Butler of Intrigue Magazine. Thank you for giving us Keith Washington.
Before we go, and I have to say this, but seeing it has, it may be the artist and their music, but it's also, it's like somebody just fast food shit, you know what I mean? Not saying the music itself. Right. So what happens, it goes, if I can sell triple platinum with this, why not? I would do it too. And then it's radio. But see, I understand one thing about it because I did radio in Detroit. I understand one thing, man. And I watched Charlie Wilson do it. He stayed in his lane and still won.
Right. That's true.
R. Kelly came, my name is Charlie. And, he came with, there goes my baby. The Gap Band could sing that same shit today.
Right.
And it's because Charlie said, I'm not bending. Jeffrey just did a tour with me, a couple of concerts with me, and Jeffrey's talking about his record. Jeffrey's out there was telling him, well, you need to go. Jeffrey says, no, I just want to do a straight up R&B record.
Right.
My fans will find it.
Exactly, exactly.
So I'm sticking to the grind of what it really means to do some real music.
And I thank you for that. Before we go, brother, because I'm burning up because I'm wearing this hot ass vest.
You're sweating too.
See? And he just got off stage. Let everybody know about your upcoming project.
This is a song called Are You Still In Love With Me? It was my second single that came off the Make Time For Love album. And I'm gonna tell you, y'all are so much responsible, I swear to God, for me going number one. And I'm gonna thank you all here in Queens, all of New York, y'all gave me love. And I've got a new album coming out, and I'm gonna show you so much love on that record. Trust and believe.
Something's wrong, and I can tell. Is it that someone came along and broke us there? There's a doubt that I can shake. Emptiness in your kiss, I'm finding hard to take. If we haven't second thoughts, if you think we should let go, after all we've been through, I should be the first to know. There's an insecurity slowly killing me. I've got to know, baby, tell me how you feel.
Somebody listen. need, even if it's just for a moment. Huh?
Feel so all alone. Where did we go wrong? Tell me now, baby, do you love me?
Tell me.
Tell me now, do you care?
Tell me.
Cause I need to know, and I'm gonna know. Hey, don't you ever, don't you ever
say
no, baby, like the way it used to be. Oh, baby, that did it all tumble down. And the pain I felt, is it there?
But you got a man, but the shit feels real good.
You better not say shit about it. He does, doesn't he? Boy, he gonna spank that butt when you get home now.
Is there somebody else? Where's another woman that needs some company? Come on down here, huh?
Hey!
Oh, thank you, my brother. Appreciate it. I was hoping you'd give me a handshake and I'm like, hey, come in, Keith. Nah, I want that shit. Women only, huh? Anybody else? Don't be ashamed. Come in, no. Come to me. Come on. Come on, bring on a bit. Come in. Come on. Don't beg or take a look at me. Can't you tell that I'm alone without you in my life? Now I'm gonna be gentle with you, baby. Sit down. This is love. Woman.
When it comes to loving me, give your tenderly one more line. Stay.
Don't be nobody ass, baby. Stay right here with me. Huh? Sweat, baby. Stay in my heart.
You look like you just kissed it, huh?
Yes, we did. You found that's that acting in me, huh? Like giving up. Where you going, baby?
But inside I knew that someday it would all work out.
Don't act like you don't know.
Keep the faith.
Oh, man, your aunt is moving her. Oh, go. No, I'm sorry. That song, oh hell no. I ain't getting my butt kicked by you. And suddenly, she was on her way though.
That's a better woman than you. And when it comes to loving me, give your all tenderly one more. Can I ask for a stay in my heart?
Stay in my heart.
I swear it is.
Ashanti Moore. But tonight, I want to bring a lovely lady that sung earlier to do this duet with me. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together. Come on, Nikkole, come on, put your hands together. Come on. Oh, yeah. Well, if you wasn't married. This song don't need no introduction, huh?
Thank you so much.